here to explain my mind map about corpus-based approach to discourse analysis. This is my mind map, and I want to write about what is corpus and kind of corpus. Next is about issue to consider in constructing a corpus. Next is about the long man spoken and written English corpus. Next is discourse characteristic on conversational English. Next is performance phenomena on conversational discourse. Next is about constructional principle of conversational discourse. And the subbab of this material is prevalence in conversation. Two is about tact in conversation. And last material is about corpus studies of the social nature of discourse. In the beginning, I want to explain about what is corpus. The explanation about corpus is generally assumed that a corpus is a collection of spoken or written authentic text that is representative of particular area of language use, the virtue of its size in composition. And next, I want to explain what kind of corpus. This is, we have some number. For number one is about general corpora. It means aim to represent language in its broadest sense and to serve as a widely available resource for baseline or cooperative studies of general linguistic features. And number two is about specialized corpora. This means a corpus of text of a particular type, such as newspaper, editorials, geography textbook, or academic article in particular subject, lecture, casual conversation, and etc. It aims to be representative of a given type of text. Number three is about the Michigan Corpus of Academic Spoken English. It means one study carried out using the MICAS corpus was an investigation of the use of hedges such as sort of, sorta, and kind of in spoken academic discourse. These were found to be more common in some disciplines, such as the humanities, than in others, such as science. And number four kind of corpus is the British Academic Spoken English Corpus. One study based on the British corpus looked at the relationship between lexical density and speed in academic lecture. Number five is about the British Academic Written English Corpus. It means this corpus examines student written assignment at different level of the study in a range of discipline with the goal of providing a database for use by researchers and teachers to enable them to identify and describe academic writing requirement in British university setting. And number six is about the TOEFL spoken and written academic language corpus. It means this corpus aims to provide a comprehensive linguistic description of spoken and written regis in U.S. universities. Next, it's about issues to consider in constructing a corpus. That must be considered in making a corpus are: first, variety or dialect of the language. Two is about the genres to be entered. And number three is whether the text should be spoken, written, or book. And next about individual corpus and text size. And last is number of texts to include in each category. Next, explanation about the long man spoken and written English corpus. It means to representing for the main types of discourse. It's about conversational, fiction, news, and prose. The two additional categories, non-conversational speech and it generate prose or non-fiction. Both the British and American conversational data were collected from a representative sample of the British and US population. And the next explanation is about this core characteristic on conversational English. In non-causal unit in conversational discourse, a key observation made in the Longman grammar is that conversational discourse make with us of non-causal unit. That is, utterance which do not contain an explicit subject or verb. And next it's about personal pronoun and ellipse in conversation. The meaning of the item and what has been left out of the conversation can usually be derived from the context in which the conversation is taking place. And the next is about situational ellipse in conversation. It means one sentence is incomplete and the meaning of the missing item or item can be derived from the immediate context rather than from as well in the text. And next is about repetition in conversation. Conversation also use repetition much more than written discourse. And the next on the list is lexical bundle in conversational discourse. It means discourse also make frequent use of lexical bundle that is formulative multi-word sequence such as it's going to be, if you want to, and or something like that. Performance phenomena of conversational discourse. It's about first silent and felt pause in conversation. The trend, launcher, and felt pauses. And next is about attention signal in conversation and response indicator in conversation. Non-causal item as response form, and the last is about extent coordination of clauses. The next subject is about constructional principle of conversational discourse. It means the principle of keep talking refers to the need to keep the conversation going while planning for the conversation is going on. The principle of limited planning ahead refers to human memory limitation planning ahead. And this material have a subject. It is preface in conversation, and number two is about text in conversation. And the explanation about prefaces in conversation is about time in part of a speaker's message is often preceded by preface, which connect what they have to say to the previous utterance, as well as giving the speaker time to point what they will say. Discourse makes and other expressions such as interjection, response form, stand advert, linking advert, overture, utterance, launcher, and the non-initial use of discourse makers. This number two is about tag in conversation. The explanation is about the speaker at tag in many ways as a afterthought to a grammatical unit in conversational discourse. And the effect of this is to turn a statement into a question tag, also can be added to the end of the statement. And my last material in my mind map is about corpus studies of the social nature of discourse. It means from the language point of view, there was fewer barriers to cross-disciplinary oral communication. Then there perhaps might be written academic communication because of the converge of speaking discourse style. generic structure of second language student, distraction, acknowledgement, the discourse structure of part of gender as well as the social role of this part of the discourse. And that is mean of corpus studies of the social network. Okay, that's all my explanation about my mind map of this course about corpus approach, and I'm sorry for my mistake in explain of this material, and thank you, and wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.